Hello and welcome back to AJM Learn. Today I want to walk through how to create really good font pairings in Squarespace, some of our favorite font pairings right now in Squarespace, and what makes a good font pairing, all those things. So this video is going to accompany the post. A lot of this is, if you're looking at this on YouTube, it'll be below in the description. You can visit the post on our website and kind of follow along and you'll get a little more information. So we walk a little bit through how to choose those font pairings. So what our rules are, you know, trying to stick to just two fonts, one for heading, one for body copy, subtle contrast. You don't want them clashing. You don't want something crazy going on between the two. We'll give lots of examples. And then just at the end of the day, keep it simple. So first, let's go into some what not to do. There's a lot of different examples broken down in the post, but I like to just kind of like do this live. It's really fun. So what not to do. First would be, let's jump in here. Let's go ahead and go to headings and browse all fonts. Okay. A lot of the fonts honestly are really, really terrible. So first and foremost, what not to do is to choose fonts that are not the same vibe. So for example, let's choose this crazy font. I wouldn't suggest ever using this font, but let's choose it just for the sake of example. Go over to our, actually, let's choose one that's like a little more useful so I can kind of show you the difference. So, okay, let's choose this font. Okay, not my favorite, but we can make it work. Over here in paragraphs, let's go to all fonts and choose this one. Okay, this looks insane. So rule number one is just don't have clashing vibes. So here we have this funky font, not my absolute favorite, but we could totally make it work. But this font gives me like medieval times. Also all caps for a body copy is a definite no. So how do we fix it? First and foremost, the body copy needs to change. It's just not legible for a body copy. All caps feels like we're screaming. For the sake of the example, I'll go up to these more common fonts, but you can choose whatever. Let's go to like Roboto. Okay, cool. So even though I don't necessarily love this heading font, this now works better. If this heading font really matches like what you're doing and you're like, this is perfect for us, we really love it, match it with this really, really clean sans serif call today. So already works so much better than the previous example. Next, a common mistake would be kind of back to where I was, but mixing, this happens a lot, I feel like, is mixing two serif fonts together. This is not like a no, not never situation, but it's not for me. This feels overwhelming. It can feel very old school. Serif fonts can be done really, really well, but this to me just feels really overwhelming. There's just serifs everywhere. It's just too much styling to me. This body copy is not particularly legible in my opinion for body copy. So actually this heading looks nice. So if we wanted this serif font, it looks really classy, classic. So let's go back into our paragraphs. And for this one, this can easily be fixed by just choosing a really classic sans serif font. So something really clean. So let's get back to our sans serifs. I don't love this one. It feels almost too modern. So you kind of got to play around with that, right? Like this is a little more classic. So you don't want your next font to be so modern. So like this one to me looks great. Nothing crazy stands out here. The weight's good. There's probably variable weights here, but the weight of these two balance each other. They don't feel, they're not competing, but at the same time, it doesn't feel like this crazy juxtaposition. So this to me works really nicely. So that's an easy way to fix that as well. lastly, kind of an example is sometimes you do want that like funky font and there's nothing wrong with that. Totally cool. So let's go into, let's start with, actually, you know what? Let's start back in paragraphs. So browse all fonts again. Let's go to, let's find another funky one. Okay, this is obviously insane, but we're going to choose this Aladdin font that's, you know, doesn't work, not legible. And then actually, this is in the example, but this is kind of a cool heading font. So this is funky for sure. It doesn't match with every single brand, but it works. This is a very uniform funky font, meaning it's not all over the place. There's not all these crazy angles. It's not tilted. It doesn't look like a child picked it out. So this still works really nicely. But this body copy is just, it just doesn't work. It's too much going on. It's two different styles, but it's also just two funky fonts, which that can really, really pull away from your branding. So back into our paragraphs for this, I would say the easy way out would be, you know, choose, this looks great. This open sans with this looks amazing. Call it a day. Doesn't clash with it, but still just has some personality, matches super, super well. Like Oswald, this would be too much. Oswald's really tall and kind of has this like weird letter spacing. I think it works better for headings personally. So this doesn't look great to me. I think something like this looks a lot nicer. We kind of just looks way more uniform. A lot of this is just kind of using your eye. Montserrat would be okay. So those would be great options. So I'll walk through now the examples from the post itself. So if you're a video person, you'd rather just watch this. Here's some options I put together. So first, modern and minimalistic. So if you want just a really clean look, here's one we're really loving. So body copy, we'll go with this one called Rig Sans. Sometimes the search is a little iffy on these. And then for our heading, we'll go back here and go to Browse All Fonts. You can just search here. Omnis Pro has several weights, so both of these do, so it's really nice. You could always play around with. For this one, I might even go back into the paragraphs and drop this to 300. I think that looks a little bit better because they felt a little bit like they were competing with that weight. So this is a font pairing we're really loving right now. It's super, super clean, super modern. Okay, next, something corporate and classic. So in our font pairing guide we used for corporate and classic, we used a lot of serif fonts. They are corporate and classic. That's kind of what we go to when we think of that. But I wanted to find something different here this time, just to mix it up and show you, okay, there can be other ways to, you know, have corporate and classic. So chose this Ivy style sans for our body copy. Again, very clean and minimalistic, but it is different than those regular sans serif fonts we're using every single day, like Roboto and Lato and all of those. And then for our heading, I'm literally obsessed with this font right now. I'm thinking of it. I think I used the sans. So I'm just thinking of this would look beautiful on, I mean, any sort of corporate website. It would look amazing at for a spa, like just anything really, really professional and clean with like earth tones. Like, I just love this. This looks amazing. So our font pairing, this is probably my favorite that I'm like really, really loving right now. And then lastly, we'll revisit something funky. So we already started with this Fat Frank before I showed you. And in the post, I have it paired with this other sans serif font. This one's cool because like this, what is it? Noble. This one is also kind of funky. This could totally stand alone as a heading font. But these, as you can see, they don't clash. They're both slightly funky, but they're both still legible. The Noble's a little bit small, so I like to resize it. But I think it works super nicely. So that's it. Those are all our favorite font pairings right now. In the post, you can get access to our font pairing guide. You'll get like 18 more font pairings for Squarespace. And we hope this helps.